Hello everyone, my name is Kumar Aditya and in this video I will try to explain the body effect in a MOSFET. So body effect is a phenomena which causes the change in the threshold voltage of a MOSFET due to the potential difference between its body and the source terminal. So if there is any voltage present between the body and the source terminal of the device, the threshold voltage will vary depending upon the magnitude of that voltage, and this is given by this particular equation here. So here Vt is the threshold voltage, Vto is the threshold voltage without any body effect, gamma is the body effect coefficient, phi is the surface potential of the device. So in this equation, Vsb is the potential present between the source and the body terminal of the device. And if this Vsb is equal to 0, you can see Vt will become equal to Vto. Now to show you this body effect in LTSpice, I have created this circuit here. So I am using this 4 terminal MOSFET symbol inbuilt in the LTSpice, and I am using this model statement to simulate a simple spice level 1 model of a MOSFET which I downloaded from the internet. So in this model, Kp is the transconductance, which is 190 micro, Vto is 0.57. So Vto is again the threshold voltage without any body effect, lambda is 0.16, gamma is 0.5, and phi is 0.7. So I will perform a DC sweep on this VGS and I will plot the ID versus VGS for different value of Vsb. So I have written this command here. So in this you can see I am varying VGS from 0 to 2 volt in the increment of 1 millivolt, and I am also varying Vsb from minus 1 volt to 2 volt in the increment of 1 volt. So if I run the simulation and plot ID versus VGS, this is the curve I get. So on the y axis I have ID, on the x axis I have VGS, and I get a set of curve for different value of Vsb. So this green one is for Vsb is equal to minus 1 volt because we started with minus 1 volt, see, and blue is for 0, red is for 1, and this is for 2 volt. And if you notice near to this x axis region, you see the threshold voltage is changing for the different value of Vsb. So this is essentially what body effect of a MOSFET describes, right? For different value of Vsb, you have different value of threshold voltage at which device will start conducting. Now for Vsb is equal to 0, which is this blue curve, threshold voltage should be equal to Vto as per this equation here. And in our model file, Vto is equal to 0.57. So let me put a cursor to see if the threshold voltage for this blue curve is 0.57 or not. So first let me zoom onto this region here. I don't think I need to put a cursor here because you can clearly observe the conduction start at VGS equal to 570 millivolt, at least very close to 570 volt. Again, you can get more accuracy if you plot the more data points. So instead of 1 millivolt, if you, let's say for example, you increment the VGS by 1 microvolt, then you get more closer to this value here, what you have described in the model statement. Now this is the mathematical explanation of the body effect in a MOSFET. Now let also understand what the physics behind it. So I will try to give you a very simple intuitive explanation of a body effect, not going too much detail into the physics, but little bit of it so that we can appreciate what actually happens inside the device. So this is the NMOS cross section I have drawn here. So you have a p-type substrate on which you have 2N plus region, heavily doped region. So you have your source and the drain region. You have your oxide layer, and top of oxide you have the metal layer which acts as a gate terminal, and this substrate is your body terminal. So you have the four terminal. Now usually biasing is done like this. Your source and body are connected together and are grounded, and we apply a voltage at the gate terminal to form the channel underneath the oxide layer. So if VG is greater than VTO, channel will form underneath the oxide layer, and shape of the channel will depend upon the magnitude of this VS and VD voltage. So like I said, VS and the source and the body terminal are connected together and are grounded. So essentially it is connected like this, right? So VS is equal to 0 here, and let's also assume that VD is 0 for now. So in this case, when we apply a gate voltage, obviously there will be electric field in this direction, and there will be formation of channel like this, and you see the shape of this channel will be rectangular. It will be rectangular like this. So depth of this channel will be uniform along the length of the channel, and this is happening because if you see, this source terminal is grounded, so it is sitting at 0 volt, and drain terminal is also at 0 volt. So potential difference between these two terminal is VG minus VS is equal to VGS, is equal to whatever voltage we are applying here, right? VG. Similarly, VG minus VD will be equal to VGD, which is equal to VG. So VGS is equal to VGD. So electric field at the source end is same as the electric field at the drain end, and therefore the channel shape is very uniform. Right, so channel depth is also uniform along the channel length. Now if we start to increase this drain voltage, so if we start to increase this drain voltage, what will happen? Your VGD will decrease, right, compared to VGS. So VGS is still the same as VG, because source is still grounded, but VD we are starting to increase, so VGD will decrease, right, and it become less than VG. So therefore VGD is less than VGS. So electric field strength at the drain end is less compared to electric field strength at the source end, and therefore your channel shape will be no longer of rectangular, but it will be of trapezoidal like this. And we are just seeing the cross section, so this is a 2D diagram. So channel shape will be something like this, and this I have explained it here in a separate drawing. So this outer box is for the case when VD is equal to 0, and when you keep on increasing the VD, you can see the channel depth keeps on decreasing at the drain end, whereas the channel depth at the source end is the same. And for a particular value of VD, your channel will be pinched off at the drain end. So this is the simplistic explanation of why pinch off condition happens in a MOSFET, right? Or a similar, whether NMOS or PMOS, you can use the same similar explanation. Now we can use the same explanation to explain the body effect as well. So let me erase this. So again, VG is greater than VTO, and let's assume that VD is also greater than 0, And now, instead of connecting this Vs to ground, we are applying a voltage here. Some voltage, let's call it Vsb. And body is again grounded. We are calling it Vsb because we are assuming our body to be the reference. And this is grounded anyway, right? So, here now Vs is no longer equal to 0. So, going by the same explanation, earlier the electric field was Vg minus Vs equal to Vg as Vs was equal to 0. But now Vs is no longer equal to 0. So, electric field Vgs will be less than Vg. So, therefore, channel depth, which should be something like this, if the source is grounded, channel will depth at the source end will also decrease and it will become something like this. This is just an explanation, right? So channel depth will decrease. Now to have the same channel depth, obviously one thing we can do is increase the voltage at the gate terminal, so that even if we are increasing, we are applying this Vs, if we increase the Vg by the same amount, total potential difference Vgs will remain the same as before, and therefore the channel depth will also remains the same, right? And same thing is what we saw in the simulation for this body effect phenomena. So when we are applying potential difference between the body and the source terminal, we have seen that the threshold voltage increased, right? Threshold voltage keeps on increasing if this Vsb is increasing. So channel depth is directly proportional to the current flowing through the device, right? More is the depth of the channel, more is the concentration of the charge in the channel, and more will be the current. So if the channel depth is decreasing, charge concentration is decreasing. So to have the same current, you have to elevate the gate voltage, and so that channel depth remains the same and you get the same current flowing through the device. So this is a very intuitive explanation, very simplistic. You can, if you are interested, you can go into the depth of the body effect in some textbook or some other video. And if you have some question regarding my explanation or some doubt regarding my explanation, you can leave that in the comment section. Bye bye.